In this lecture, I'm going to load total likes count for each blog and I'm going to add likes counter short functionalities to our GetBlocks API endpoint. Our GetBlocks API endpoint is calling blog controllers list method. And to load total likes count for each blog, we need to modify this project object. So I'll add a new key inside this project object and the key name will be likes underscore count. And then I'll provide an object here, and inside this object I'll provide dollar size because we need to count the size of this blog underscore likes array. So I'll provide an object as a value, and then inside this object I'll provide a condition, and the condition will be dollar if null. And I'm adding this condition because if a blog don't have any likes, then this dollar size will count the data from a blank array. So I'll provide a blank array inside an array second value, and in the first value I'll provide blog underscore likes, because if a blog has some likes, then this dollar size will count the data from this blog underscore likes array. Now let's execute our GetBlocks API endpoint from Postman. You see, now we have likes count for each blog. Now let's check our likes count or short functionality is working or not. Let's provide short by field as likes count and short order descending. You see, now we are getting the blog which has most likes in the first position. And then let's change the short order to ascending. You see, now we have the blog which has least likes in the first position. So our likes count or short functionality is working because all of our blogs now have this likes count field, and we are providing this short by field data and short order data dynamically to this short object. You see, I provided short by field and plus 1 for short order ascending and minus 1 for short order descending dynamically to this short object. That's why our likes count to a short functionality is working properly. Okay. Now I'm going to load likes count for the blog data which we are returning from this blog details endpoint. So I'll copy this code from here and I'll paste that code inside the project object which is present inside our details method. So let's provide this code inside this project object, and I'm gonna load total likes count for newly created blog data also. So I'll modify the project object which is present inside this create method also. So let's provide this code inside this project object, and I'll also add this code inside the project object which is present inside our update method, because I'm going to load total likes count for updated blog data. So let's provide this code inside this project object, and now let's execute our blog data endpoint. You see, we have likes count for this blog. Now I'm gonna add a new key to this data object to check is this blog already liked by currently authenticated user or not. So if an user is providing API token through authorization header, then we will not get currently authenticated user data from request user key, because our blog details endpoint don't have this auth middleware. So if an user is providing API token through authorization header, then we will not get currently authenticated user data from request user key. But we cannot use this auth middleware to our blog details endpoint, because this endpoint will not be protected all the time, right? So how we will get currently authenticated user data from request user key if an user is providing a API token through authorization header? For this, what I will do, I will create a new middleware function inside our middleware.js file. So from our middleware.js file, let's export a new method called API, and let's get request response and next as a parameter to this method. Also, let's copy this code from here and paste it here. And now I'll check if token, that means user is providing API token through authorization header, then I'll verify the token and I'll store currently authenticated user data to request user key, right? So let's copy this code from here and paste this inside this if block. So from this catch block, we do not need to return any JSON response. So let's remove this code from here. And from this else block, we do not need to return any JSON response. So what am I doing here? I am verifying the token with the help of JWT verify method. And if this token is verified, then we can get the data from this decoded variable. And we are storing currently authenticated user data to this request user key. And then we need to call this next method here. Okay, now let's use this API middleware to this block details endpoint. So I'm gonna add API middleware to this endpoint. Now if an user is providing API token through authorization header, then we'll get kindly authenticated user data from request user key. So let's check it. So let's get back to our details method. And I'm going to store currently authenticated user data to a variable called current underscore user, and I'm going to create the variable inside this if block, because we need to check is the block liked by currently authenticated user or not inside this if block. So I'll provide currently authenticated user data to a new variable called current underscore user, and we'll get kindly authenticated user data from request user key. And this will be null if the token is not valid or user is not providing API token through authorization header. This will be null or undefined, right? So I will check if current user, that means user is providing valid API token through authorization header, then I will check if there is any record inside our block likes collection with this current user ID and with this blog ID. Okay, so let's store this blog data to a new variable called blog and store that data here, and then let's provide this variable to this blog.hided method. And I'll also modify the data object here. So I'm gonna provide blog data to a new key called blog, and I'm gonna add a new meta key to our data object, and we'll provide liked by current user, and we need to provide true or false, right? So for now let's provide false here. This will be very helpful when we will implement this API endpoint in any front-end application like Node.js, Angular, Vue.js or React.js, right? So right now I'm providing like by current user as a hard-coded data, and right now it's false, but we'll make this dynamically. So I'll create a new variable here, and the variable name will be liked by current user, and this will be false by default. And then I'll provide this variable as a value to this liked by current user key, and then inside this if block, that means user is providing API token through authorization header, then I'll check if there is any record inside our blog likes collection with this current user ID and this blog ID. Okay, so we can query our blog likes collection with the help of blog like model, and I'm going to query with the help of find on method, and I'll provide the condition inside an object, and the first condition will be blog ID, which will be the ID of this blog, and then the second condition will be user ID, and this will be our currently authenticated user ID. So let's provide current user dot underscore ID. Okay, and this will return as a promise. So I'll use await here, and I store the blog like data to a variable called blog like, and I'll check if any like data found inside our blog likes collection with this condition, then I'll modify this value, right? So if any like found, then this liked by current user will be true, right? Now Let's call our block details endpoint again. You see, now we are getting like by current user inside this meta object, right? So now I'll provide API token through authorization header. So we can generate API token with the help of login API, and I'm generating API token for this user, and then I'll copy the token from here and I'll paste this authorization hello for our block details endpoint. You see, now we are getting like by current user is equal to true. That means the block of this ID is already liked by this user. That's why we are getting liked by current user is equal to true. Now if I remove this authorization token, then you see what we are getting. Now we are getting liked by current user false, right? Now let's add this again and call it. This will be liked by current user is true. Now if I remove the like for this block and for this user with the help of toggle like API endpoint. Now if I remove the like for the ID, for the block of this ID and with this token, and this is the token of this user. You see, we remove the like. Now if I execute our block details endpoint, we will get liked by current user to false. We are providing API token also, right? You see, because this user is not like this block already, right? That's why we are getting liked by current user is equal to false. Now let's add like. You see, like successfully added, and execute our block details endpoint. It should be true. You see, so we already added total likes count for each block, and we already added likes count to our short functionalities to our getbox API endpoint, and we also modified our block details endpoint to check is this block already liked by current user or not if an user is providing API token through authorization header. And in the next lecture, I'm going to create change password API endpoint in Node.js. So stay connected.